Hi everybody, it's Sunday, the last video of the week. So, today, everything is back to normal. I took the pill last night on time. I took the Wellbutrin this morning. So everything is getting back in order. I got a phone call from one of my brothers, not my oldest one. My oldest one, he'll call and we'll talk and stuff, but he mostly talks about himself. He doesn't really talk about me, like my problems. So, you know, his visits or his calls, they're nice, but they're not really, I won't say meaningful, but they're just, I don't know. So this is my other brother, the only one who genuinely calls me, and we talk about a little bit of everything, and we talk about me, we talk about him, and everybody else in the family. And so, because I haven't spoken to him since he moved. He just moved to a new place, and he was having a hard time in the new place because the landlord was supposed to have some things ready and they weren't, and so there was like a back and forth. And so, but now everything's settled and he's okay, so he's able to call me and we're able to catch up. So, I don't mind talking to him. You know, sometimes I don't want to talk to him because, you know, he's very straightforward. He wants to know exactly what is going on. And, if he doesn't like your answer, he will tell you. So, he wanted to know very specifics. Okay, so, you know, he doesn't like my current living situation. He doesn't like my husband. None of my family likes my husband. You know, they don't understand how he can have an affair and basically, I mean, we used to have it all. And he threw that all away. And so they can't understand that. You know, that's the thing that a normal couple strives for. You know, the house and the kids and, you know, that kind of life to keep going. That's what a marriage is. And so, but he didn't want that, and he threw that away for someone. And so, my family doesn't like him for that. They think he's a royal asshole. And so, my brothers especially. My brother cannot stand him, and he doesn't like that he lives with me, and that I am broke all the time, unemployed, sick, depressed. You know, my brother's concerned. He's like, this man is toxic for you. This man is feeding into your sickness. And so he, you know, my brother just wants me to be strong, you know, and I get that, I do, but it's hard. And he wants me to basically just kick this guy to the curb and just like start my life and stuff. And I'm telling him I can't do that. I have bills that need to get paid, you know. I have him on child support, but the child support hasn't kicked in yet. So I don't know, I mean, where am I gonna get money from? I told my brother, I mean, there's two choices for me. I mean, I've been applying to places and they don't call me back. And I mean, I could either work in a bar or be a stripper. I mean, those are like the immediate openings right now for me. My brother was not too happy with that. He's like, if I catch you in either one of those places, I will pull you by the little hair you have and drag you out of there. And all the while, my foot going up your asshole. So, he doesn't like that. He thinks I can do better than that. And I agree, but it's hard. I've been looking. It's frustrating. No one wants to hire me. I suck at everything. So, he was asking me about my car. Now, my car was told to me that it was going to get fixed on Friday. And here we are on Sunday. I have no car. So, that pissed my brother off. He was like, why? Where is the money going? Why is your car not fixed? And so I had to tell him, like, look, I don't know. He's the one with the money, and I can't rush him because then he gets pissed and he's like, you know what, fuck it, I'm not gonna fix anything. And that's how he works. If he doesn't like what he hears, he knows that he can just leave and leave me with nothing. And so my brother was upset about that. It's like everything my brother kept asking me, all my answers just kept making him get more mad. Like, I was picturing him on the other end of the line, slowly turning green and like the clothes shredding up and ripping up and stuff. So I'm like, oh, the Hulk on the other end of the line. Any minute he's gonna bust through my wall like the Kool-Aid Man, and the show will begin. So then he asked about my health. So I was telling him, look, I've started the medication, and my brother doesn't like that. He thinks the therapy is a little out there, but he doesn't like me taking any kind of pills. He thinks that I will get addicted and that I will get lazy and dumb, or dumber, like he said. That's his sense of humor. And that, he doesn't like it. But I told him that, I know it's not a cure. It's like a little band-aid, kind of. It's just going to help, heal the boo-boo a little bit. And it's just going to help me. What's wrong with that? And then he told me that I was too skinny. He was like, listen, you have been posting pictures lately, and I'm looking at the pictures, and you're skinnier from the last time that I saw you. And you need to start eating. You need to eat. And so I was telling him that I've been eating more and stuff. And that's impossible that I'm thinner now than the last time I saw him, because the last time I saw him, I weighed less. And so, and I've been hearing that. I've heard that like a few times already. I don't get it. How can I weigh more now and look less? And back then it was less weight. And I don't understand. So I told him, to don't worry, that I'm eating more. And so he flat out asked me how much I weigh. Oh boy. I didn't tell him. Now, the minute he asked me that, something happened. Something clicked in my head. I was kind of like, I think I'm gonna stop telling people how much I weigh, because it is starting to trigger me. Before it didn't, now it does. It bothers me. I don't like it. I think that unless I say, today I weigh yada yada, unless I'm telling you, that must mean I'm not comfortable. So I think that I don't want to be asked anymore how much I weigh. I think that's incredibly personal. That's the equivalent of someone asking you how much do you make a year, or how much do you make at your job. That's like none of your fucking business. So unless you're willing to share, I think you shouldn't be obligated to answer. So, I mean, there's a lot of triggering things that get said to me on a daily basis by people who don't have eating disorders that I don't think they realize what they're saying to me, about my weight, my appearance. Comments, people ask me for tips to lose weight. I mean, all that's triggering me. Yeah. That's why I say it's important to invest and try to find out. When someone says, I have an eating disorder, I think you, as the loved one, whether it be related by blood or just a good friend, or a boyfriend or a girlfriend or a husband or a wife, I mean, I think you have the obligation to, you should obligate yourself to Google, read a book, watch a movie, find out about this person's sickness, because it is sickness. It is a mental illness. And do your part and try to find out what's going on, To me, that shows caring. And to me, I think if anyone non-disordered were to do that, then I would consider you more. I would open up to you more, I would trust you more. But, you know, people that I've met, that I've come out to, zero have done that. So I can't give you 100%. I won't. You know, I'm gonna treat you okay. You know, I'm gonna care for you and whatnot, but I'm not, I know where I stand. And so I'm not gonna go the extra mile. Now my brother knows that, he knows about the eating disorder. He doesn't understand it. You know, he doesn't get it. He knows that I don't eat. He doesn't know about the binging and the purging. God, I would never tell him that. If I told him, God, he would think I was a fucking monster, you know? Like, who the fuck does that? That's gross. And so, I would be mortified if he found out about that. So he just thinks that I don't eat. And so that's fine, you know. I guess I prefer that. I prefer people to think that I just don't eat. So. But, you know, he just tells me to eat. Like, that's, like, he doesn't get it. And so he thinks it's just me choosing not to eat. Or me choosing to be like this. And trust me, no one chooses this. That's like someone choosing to have cancer. I mean, something that happens to you. You don't want it, you know? Or someone choosing to be gay. You don't choose that. You're born that way. I mean, there's something genetically predisposed. You know, people get eating disorders. There are people in the family, there are factors that contribute to it. I mean, there's a lot of information on eating disorders that if you look up as a loved one, you will find out and you will see. But a lot of people don't invest. They don't make the time to, so. And I'm not going to be your teacher. If you care about me, you make the effort. So I told them that I was going to eat more and that I'm trying or whatever, but. So, yeah, he was pretty upset. You know, he didn't like any of my answers. And I didn't like any of my responses. They were coming out, to be honest. But, I mean, I can't really do anything right now. I'm just kind of stuck. So, during this conversation, my husband is getting ready for work. And my husband likes to be strong. So, I get into an argument with my husband. Because he thinks that, from what he was listening to, he thinks that I'm making him look like a bad guy, like he is a bad person. And I told him, look, I'm not making you look like anything. If people don't like you, that's their business. I mean, God, you can't fight with me if someone doesn't like you. Like, that doesn't make any sense. So, I mean, it is what it is. I can't do anything more. He's like, you're supposed to be, oh, now the new thing is, you're supposed to be getting better. Now you're on the pills. Now you're supposed to be getting better. And I keep explaining to him, yeah, I'm supposed to get better. I don't know what you think the pill's going to do. The pill's not going to make me fall back in love with you. The pill's not going to make this marriage work again. That's nothing to do with medication or therapy. That's not going to happen. I mean, you need to stop putting all that pressure on me. I feel bad as it is. I feel stupid living with someone who, yeah, you're paying my bills and you're my kid's father and all that, but I mean, I'm an adult and I'm a woman and a human being and I get lonely and I am lonely. I have a lot that I want to give to someone and there's no one to give it to. And so living with someone, having someone there all the time, it's just taking up space in my life. You know, you're suffocating me. You're taking up my oxygen. So, he didn't like hearing that. And yes, I did tell him that. My sister, sometimes she'll ask me, like, well, but you told him that? I'm like, yeah, like, I'm sorry, sometimes I'm a little bit too brutal in my honesty, but I have to be. I don't know how to make things pretty. I didn't grow up like that, painting little pretty pictures and, oh, Santa Claus leaves presents under the tree. I didn't grow up like that. I grew up being taken to the store and, okay, what do you want for Christmas? Like, there was no Santa Claus. You know, there is no Easter Bunny. I didn't grow up like that. So, forgive me if I'm just a bit hard. And the years have hardened me further, so. But yeah, I told him, like, you know, it hurts to say that to you because you have feelings, but so do I. And, you know, it's just an impasse. You know, we can't get past anything, so. He just finally just left to work. And so now I have a huge headache, I feel drained. So I'm gonna change the subject because I'm really depressing. Paradot, you asked me in your last post, your last comment about Dr. Calico. Now, Dr. Calico, I'm afraid, he had a friend, Mr. Hippopotamus, because my daughter can't say hippopotamus, so she says hippopotamus. And the hippo was Dr. Calico's friend slash henchman, and so he converted sides to the good guys. So now Dr. Calico is all by his lonesome. So I don't know if you wanna, if you're working on stitching little friends, then Dr. Calico could use somebody because he sits in the corner with his big black button eye that I sewed, and he's very lonely. And all he does is just plot and plot and plot, and he has no one to scheme with. So. Yeah, so that's where that stands. So today I'm gonna go ahead and start cooking, making some fettuccine alfredo for dinner, and just relaxing my kid today. It looks like it wants to rain. I don't know. Tomorrow's 4th of July. I don't know. I'm gonna see if I can get some little sparklers. My daughter's scared of all the loud bangy ones. Like, she doesn't mind like the pretty ones that light up quietly on the floor. Or like the sparklers. The sparklers are my favorite. But she doesn't like the firecrackers and the big bang ones and all that. She's scared of that. So I'm gonna go ahead and just rack up on like little pretty ones and all that for tomorrow. And that's it. That's all. So I'm gonna go, guys. I hope y'all are doing well. And we'll talk again next week. And we'll see what happens tomorrow. So I hope you all have a good 4th of July. Those that are celebrating it, and for the rest of you guys, just hang in there, and you know, let's start the week differently. So that's it. Bye, guys.